G'day guys, Calvin, Cartoon Company in New Zealand. I'm wiring yet another UZ, this time with a Haltech ECU. We're doing step by step, little bites. I'm putting it all together. I've done the cam and cranks, and this moment now, I'm gonna do the knock sensors. Standard, these have a single pin knock sensor in them. I happen to have upgraded this one. So we're putting a Bosch knock sensor. We built this little loom to go underneath the manifold. That's what I was thinking of, intake manifold. We're fitting Bosch two-pin knock sensors to it. We have the instructions. When all else fails, read the instructions. But a lot of guys would do really well to read them before they start pulling wires. Also fantastic help function in the software. So the knock sensors are in the B plug, which is where I put the cam and crank sensors, in the same plug. There's two of them in this. I'm doing an Elite 2500. So as this loom here, this one, runs under the intake manifold, we've actually already made that. It's already fitted to the engine. We've got this Deutsch plug that we use at the back. I'm running in the starter trigger. I'm running in an earth, which is common to both of the knock sensors, and then the left hand and the right hand. I'm running, the left hand is going into number one input, which is on pin 21 of the B plug, so B21. And the right hand is going into knock two, which is B22. So I've already terminated this up. And we're putting the start in. Now I used a piece of 3-core Tefzel wire, shielded wire. So at the other end, I have taken the shield and I've added an earth to it. And you only earth the shield at one end. I'm going to make the orange trace wire number one and the blue trace wire number two. And if you're having trouble remembering where number one and number two goes, a little trick to remember is generally number one is number one knock sensor, bank number one is related to where number one cylinder is, which happens to be right here on the left hand side of the engine. Taken from when you're in the car, from when you're driving it. Makes it really easy, so we don't do left and right standing from the front of the vehicle, because that just confuses everyone. With that in there, put back here, and here's my wire. So the earth and the shield is joined up in here. It's going to be joined to the signal ground, which can be either B14, 15 or 16. I'm going to take this and I'm going to count the pins. Number 20 is at the bottom left hand. So we go 20, 21 is the next one in. Number one was the orange trace. Check it pops all the way in. And blue trace is number two, the right hand. Now, if you're using a pre-terminated loom, fly loom, then that's already done for you. And you just have to connect them at the other end. Single wire, of course, are really simple because there's only one wire. Can get new connectors, makes it really easy. Right, that's the knock sensors done on my 1UZ to Haltech wiring loom.